Welcome back. Daybreak is all local all morning. It's Saturday, so we're highlighting a local company with Indiana Grown, and I've got Don Barnes with me from the Society of St. Andrews. We're glad to have you on today.
Thank you.
I'm already doing some research here, and the first thing that I saw here is you guys are gleaning America's fields, and I'm looking at going, you mean cleaning? Is that a typo? Tell folks what gleaning is and why it's so important to what you do.
Sure. Gleaning is an age-old term that is coming from the Old Testament, from the Book of Ruth, where farmers were called to leave the corners of their field for the poor and the orphan. And bring that forward to 2020, and we're still gleaning the fields with farmers across the U.S. And specifically here in Indiana, we work with about 30 or 40 farmers where we glean their fields, and we donate that directly to local hunger relief organizations.
So what does that look like? Is it going to the fields after the big machines have gone down and you're getting what's left, or are you getting a section of the fields?
Each farmer is different. We have gleaned 200-acre cucumber farmers here in Indiana, and sometimes that's a pickup from a local farmer of 30 or 40 pounds of squash or carrots that are left over that are too big or not marketable for their markets, and we pick those up and donate those directly to try to keep it as local as possible.
So they're like funny looking cucumbers that taste great, but just look a little
exactly, odd. Exactly, yes.
I think a lot of folks can get on board with this because they look at, for instance, a farmer's market, right, that has a huge spread of food. And at the end of the day, maybe they didn't sell everything and it's going to go bad in a matter of days. Do you work with farmer's markets then,
yes,
for things like
that
too?
Yes, we farmer's markets. We work with community gardens and those big farms. So we do it all and try to get as much as we can that doesn't go to waste and get that into on the plate of somebody who needs it.
I imagine that you have a lot of community support then, not only people saying, yes, come help glean my produce that's not going to make it, but then people who want to volunteer and say, I want to put some muscle behind this idea.
Yes, we can always use people to come out and volunteer with us. We currently are gleaning the downtown Indy market, the winter market.
Oh,
and
yeah, winter
market.
We are
doing
market.
Some distribution of boxes where we can always use volunteers, and you can easily go up and sign up on our website.
I imagine you've got some COVID precautions in place too, but this is a good way for people to kind of get out and use their hands and do something physical while still staying.
Absolutely. Great way to social distance and help out your neighbor.
And get to be a part of this.
Yes.
I imagine this year has been especially big for you with the pandemic, and as we've reported on Daybreak, that food insecurity has gone up.
Absolutely, yes. We've gone from about 13% to over 24% food insecurity, and it's a big need, and this is one great way to not only help out, but to get involved as well.
So then how can folks get involved? You got a website sign up kind of a thing?
www.endhunger.org. You can go on and sign up and volunteer today.
Endhunger.org. It's a national group then.
Yes, we're a national organization with a local office here in Indianapolis we're working throughout the state.
That's fantastic. Do you have plans for today? Any gleaning projects on the calendar?
Indy Winter Market will be there gleaning at 12 o'clock.
Right after it's done.
Yes.
There we go. Okay, well, good luck.
Great.
We certainly
Thank
hope you,
you
get a lot of folks who come and join in, of course, Society of St. Andrews, gleaning with a capital G, America's Fields to help the hungry. Thanks again for coming
Thank
in,
you.
Dawn.